Yeah, this is an input mode. We have a different ports of inputs like channel 1, channel 2, channel 3, channel 4, channel 5 and channel 6. Individual ports can be used. Like if we want to add 3 devices, each individual in left right channel 1, 2, left right channel 3, 4 and left right channel 5, 6. We can do it, or we can use 4 channel output of a music system to connect in channel 1, 2, 3, 4. We can do like that also. We have an auxin head unit input for an Alpine processor if we need to connect through Alpine head unit, or a changer can also be connected to this thing with the Alpine AINet cable. These are two optical inputs for Alpine head units and changer. They are giving an optical input also. This is a power supply to connect the battery, to connect your remote to ground, and also to power your amplifier. There is a remote output over here. Change. These are all outputs. Now, if you need to connect your 4-channel amplifier along with your subwoofer, you can connect from here, or you can also connect 2 subwoofers and use it for mono to 5-channel, 6-channel, 7-channel, 8-channel as in mono output for 2 amplifiers, and rest 1, 2, 3, 4-channel for connecting your 4 speakers to your 4-channel amplifier. This is a cable for commander. You have to connect this commander cable to control this commander. This is commander controller, which can command each and everything. And this is PC cable. This cable is connected to your computer for your which gives in software also. Software CDs are coming also along with this. And this is a USB port which is going to be connected with the laptop. So next, as we switch on the ignition and the amplifier switch, the processor switches on. We need to quick on. This an Alpine thing comes. Then you have to go into setup. In setup, you have to go into multi input setup like this. Output first, output setup. What type of setup you are looking into? Like if your system selects, you have a front two-way speaker, rear speakers and subwoofer, or you have put it only a three-way component speaker with subwoofer, or your three-way plus rear speakers. What type of in channel output setups you have done? Like if we are putting two-way in the front speakers and a coaxial speaker or a back speakers and with a, along with the subwoofer, we will select this thing and we will put OK to it. Now it is asking whether your component are bi-amped, means you are putting an extra amplifier to it and using 8 channel to this output of this to your bi-amping to the amplifier or not. For that you can do either this full range or a tweeter if you are, or an off. If you are saying it's off, it means your next, it's a full range speakers we are going through it. Next is for the rear, whether it is on or off. If you are using the rear speakers, put it on. Now the next is subwoofer 1. If you are connecting one subwoofer, then you say on to one and off to another. But if you are putting two subwoofers, you have to say both channels on. Subwoofer channel should be mono or stereo. Like if you want to put two subwoofers, then you can select it for mono or stereo. Left right subwoofering also can be done according to the sound. We are selecting here mono. Then comes the aux input setup. Aux input setup means your input setup is 5.1 channel input. Like if your system has an output for 5.1 channel, you can connect directly to it to 5.1 channel, or a 4 into 2 channel input like 4 channel pre-outs and a 2 channel input pre-out for subwoofer, you will opt for this thing. Then say select OK. Then it's asking whether you are connecting through your speaker output or connecting through your preamp output. If you are connecting through preamp output, go to low frequencies, and your aux 2 if you are connected through speaker output, or an this is for speaker output, and this is for your RC preamp output connected for off. Now it says you have to switch off your ignition. once you switch off your ignition, your whole setup will be get into the memory of the system. Sirf memory ignition ki tarah hata hai, blue wali tar, remote ki wali. Now we have switch on off the ignition. Now connect the ignition.